Mobileye, a division of Intel, continues to push forward on autonomous driving technology. The company recently announced that they expect consumers to have access to these vehicles within 5 years. Joining me to discuss all this and more is Jack Weast. He's the Vice President of Autonomous Vehicle Standards at Mobileye, an Intel company. So Jack, when we saw you at CES last year, Mobileye's mapping strategy was the big buzz of the conference. Can you talk a little bit about how that technology is advancing this year?
Absolutely, thanks Alexis. It's great to see you virtually this year. We originally announced our mapping technology, REM, Roadbook Experience Management, almost 5 years ago. And so what we're really sharing with the world today is that the technology is real and it's being deployed globally. Across hundreds of thousands of vehicles, we are collecting millions of kilometers of mapping data on a daily basis from vehicles in over half a dozen manufacturers around the world. And this gives us a significant advantage in the sense of our ability to scale and deploy mobility as a service around the world. COVID has made development of automated vehicles challenging. And so we were able to recently send a car from Israel to Germany, where we don't have engineers and we couldn't fly engineers because of COVID. And because we'd already had Germany mapped because of our vehicles that we have driven by human drivers with driver assistance in it, that vehicle was able to get up and running in a matter of days. And so that ability to scale our deployments of our autonomous test vehicle fleets today and the commercial deployments tomorrow is enabled by our unique crowdsource mapping technology.
Right. And as you talked about, this ability to scale is part of what differentiates you from your competitors. Your company made the conscious decision to look at the camera first technology to start with the hard technology. Can you talk about how that implementation of that business strategy is working out for you?
You know, it's working out fantastic. The traditional approach to mapping is you have these really expensive LiDAR-based vehicles. You have a small fleet of these. You send them out in months in advance to a city that you'd like to deploy in. You send even more expensive engineers out there with those vehicles and you drive them around and around and around. You would take big hard drives out, ingest them into a data center. It's incredibly labor intensive and expensive to do that. And if that's what has to be done before you could deploy to a new city or even expand the area of operation in a city you're already in, that's not a way to build a scalable business. So we realized that we had a unique opportunity because we have a crowd of tens of millions of humans driving driver assistance enabled vehicles today. And so our camera-based technology was mature enough that we can map the world with cameras. We don't need specialized LiDAR mapping vehicles, and even better, we can map the world with vehicles that you and I are driving on a daily basis. A tiny trickle of about a kilobyte per kilometer of data is all that is needed to send up to the cloud to aggregate together information to enable our AV maps.
You talked about your plans for scaling up. So what cities are you planning on targeting next?
Yeah, we are announcing this week that we are now operating in Detroit. We hope to bring cars to New York City. We're going to bring cars to Tokyo, to Shanghai, to Paris. We already have vehicles operating in Munich, as well as Israel. And so I challenge the investor community to look at any other robotaxi vendor who has that many different vehicles operating in that many different environments. And think about how different the driving style is, you know, in all of those different countries. Think about how different the signage is and the road infrastructure. And so our ability to operate simultaneously in these wildly different environments, I think, is an excellent example of not only the strength of that map asset, which allows us to put vehicles on the road there in the first place, but also the maturity of our vision algorithms, which have been matured over a decade in their deployment of driver assistance systems in cars all around the world. So we can already operate in Tokyo because we know what street signs look like in Tokyo. We can already operate in Germany because of the same. So that ability to scale because of the scale of our driver assistance systems provides an outstanding foundation for our ability to scale robotaxi services in the future.
And it's so exciting as a consumer, but also for investors, because I feel like, you know, every time we talk about autonomous vehicle technology, it always seems so far off, but we're really looking at consumers possibly being able to use these vehicles within the next few years. Can you talk a little bit about the importance with partnerships or anything that you're looking at with Mobileye and Intel?
Yeah, it's incredibly exciting. And so, you know, certainly consumers are going to have the opportunity to enjoy a robotaxi experience, say 2022. But we realized that, you know, in order for us to enjoy this technology ourselves in a car that we could afford, it needs to be affordable. It needs to be in a car that we can afford, but also consumers have certain expectations. When we buy a car, we expect that we can drive it anywhere. And so when we buy a car with self-driving capability, we should expect it's going to be able to take us anywhere we could drive that vehicle ourselves. And so in order to accomplish those dual goals, we need to not only bring down the cost of the self-driving system, but we also need to increase its capabilities, because no longer would it be acceptable for us to have a car that says, no, it will only operate in a self-driving mode in a geofenced area. You know, that's not going to be acceptable to a consumer. And so to achieve this goal, we're announcing this week the investment and creation of a brand new kind of LiDAR chip that Intel will be manufacturing in Intel's very unique fab that has the ability to combine active and passive LiDAR elements in a single SoC package. We've also announced plans to create a software-defined radar that will allow radar chips to work like cameras and do object detection and classification with a radar chip alone. And so this will allow us to reduce the cost of sensors, increase the capability of the product, and give consumers a vehicle that they can afford that will be able to drive them anywhere that they would reasonably drive themselves.
Hey everyone, thanks so much for watching Investors Business Daily on YouTube. If you want to watch more videos, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a thing.